Please note, all scenes in this video are sample procedures based on the PIDAC environmental cleaning best practices. However, your procedures may vary according to the tools, equipment, and cleaning products being used within your facility. Also, the use of any logos and products seen in this video is not intended as an endorsement.
Note, if using two separate products for cleaning and for disinfection, repeat steps 1 to 11 with disinfectant after completing step 11, and repeat steps A to K with disinfectant after completing step K. Before cleaning a regular room after discharge and vacancy, check for contact precautions, droplet precautions, and airborne precaution signs. And if present, use applicable room cleaning protocol. Gather materials required for cleaning before entering the room, including an adequate supply of clean cloths, fresh cleaning solution, and hospital-grade disinfectant, which may be combined in one product, a dust mop, and wet mop and bucket, or microfiber mop. Clean your hands with alcohol-based hand rub. If your hands are visibly soiled, you must use soap and water to clean them. Put on gloves and enter the room. Strip the bed and pillows, discarding linen into a soiled linen bag. Roll the sheets carefully to prevent aerosols from getting into the air. Inspect the bedside curtains and window treatments. And if they are visibly soiled, clean or change them. Discard personal care items that may have been left by the patient resident, for example, lotions, creams, comb, and magazines. Remove soiled linen from the floor and place it in a linen bag, then remove the soiled linen bag. Remove debris from the floor and place it in a waste receptacle. Remove the waste, handling plastic bags from the top, but do not compress with hands. Clean the waste can holder if it is soiled. Be alert for needles and other sharp objects, and pick them up using a mechanical device. Then place them in a sharps container and report the incident to your supervisor. Remove your gloves and discard. Clean your hands with alcohol-based hand rub. If your hands are visibly soiled, you must use soap and water to clean them. Put on fresh gloves. When cleaning, use a fresh cloth saturated with cleaning solution disinfectant. Clean with one cloth at a time. Do not double dip the same cloth into the cleaning solution or shake a cloth. Change the cleaning cloth when it is no longer saturated with solution and after cleaning heavily soiled areas. Set the cloth aside for laundering and use a fresh cloth to continue. Place soiled cloths in a designated container or a bag for laundering. If there is more than one patient resident bed space in the room, use fresh cloths for each and complete the cleaning in each bed space before moving to the next. When working from least soiled areas or low touch to most soiled areas or high touch and from high surfaces to low surfaces, proceed with the following steps. 1. Clean doors, door handles, push plate, and touched areas of the frame. 2. Check walls for visible soiling and clean if required. Remove tape from walls and clean stains. 3. Clean light switches and thermostats. 4. Clean wall-mounted items such as the alcohol-based hand rub dispenser, the glove box holder, the top of the suction bottle, intercom, and blood pressure gauge. 5. If Environmental Services is responsible for checking and replacing sharps containers, check sharps container and change when sharps reach the fill line. Clean sides and bottom of the sharps container, but do not dust the top of the sharps container. 6. Check and remove fingerprints and soil from low-level interior glass partitions, glass door panels, mirrors, and windows with glass cleaner. 7. Clean all furnishings and horizontal surfaces in the room, including chairs, windowsill, television, telephone, night tables or desks, support railings, ledges and shelves, and pay particular attention to high-touch surfaces. 8. Clean patient-resident equipment that is not cleaned by the nursing staff, such as IV pole, walker, or wheelchair. Note, if the patient resident has been using a commode chair, it should be cleaned as part of the room cleaning and as per facility procedure. 9. Clean the inside and outside of the patient resident cupboard or locker. 10. Clean the bed, working in a systematic fashion from the foot of the bed to the head of the bed. Clean the top and sides of the mattress, and then turn the mattress over and clean the underside. Make sure you also clean the exposed bed springs and frame. Check for cracks or holes in the mattress, and have the mattress replaced as required. You must also clean the pillows. In addition, you must inspect for pests. Clean the footboard, headboard, bed rails, call bell, and bed controls as well. It is essential that you pay particular attention to areas that are visibly soiled and surfaces that are frequently touched by staff, patients, or residents. Clean all lower parts of bed frame, including casters. 11. If there is a sink in the room, clean inside and outside of the sink, sink faucets, and mirror. Wipe plumbing under the sink. Apply disinfectant to the interior of the sink, ensuring sufficient contact time with the disinfectant. Rinse sink and fixtures and wipe dry. Clean the bathroom. Begin the bathroom cleaning procedure by using a fresh cloth saturated with cleaning solution disinfectant. A. Clean the door, door handles, push plate, and touched areas of the frame. B. Check walls for visible soiling and clean if required. C. Clean the light switch. D. Clean chrome wall attachments. E. Clean all wall-mounted dispensers and frames. F. Check and remove fingerprints and soil from mirror with glass cleaner. G. Clean the call bell and cord. H. Clean support railings, ledges, and shelves. I. Apply toilet bowl disinfectant to the toilet bowl and allow it to remain while cleaning the sink and shower tub to ensure enough contact time with the disinfectant. J. When cleaning the sink, clean all surfaces around the sink, vanity, or countertop. Clean inside and outside of the sink, sink faucets, and the mirror. K. Wipe plumbing under the sink. Apply disinfectant to the interior of the sink, ensuring sufficient contact time with the disinfectant. Rinse the sink and fixtures and wipe dry. When cleaning the shower tub area, clean inside and outside the area. Clean faucets, walls, and railing, scrubbing as required to remove soap scum. Inspect grout for mold and apply disinfectant to interior surfaces of the shower tub, including soap dish, faucets, and shower head. Make sure that there is enough contact time for the disinfectant. Rinse the shower tub and fixtures and wipe dry. Inspect and replace shower curtains monthly and as required. Finish cleaning the toilet. Clean the toilet handle, clean all exterior surfaces of the toilet, clean underside of the flush rim, clean the toilet bowl, and flush the toilet. Once this is done, carefully remove gloves and clean your hands with alcohol-based hand rub. If your hands are visibly soiled, you must use soap and water to clean them. Replenish paper towels, toilet paper, toilet brush or swab, and waste bag as required. Also replace empty soap, lotion, and alcohol-based hand rub containers with fresh supplies as required, but do not top up liquid containers. Put on fresh gloves. When dry mopping the floor, start at the back of the room and work towards the door. You must keep the dust mop on the floor at all times once you've started, and use the swivel motion of the frame and wrist to change direction. Take your time to minimize any turbulence to prevent the dispersion of dust. Then carefully dispose of debris, being careful not to stir up dust. And do not shake the mop. Remove the mop head for laundering. When wet mopping the floor, note that disinfectant is not required for the floors. If you are using a loop mop and bucket, place a wet floor caution sign outside of room or area being mopped. Immerse the mop in cleaning solution and wring it out. Start at the back of the room and work towards the door. Push the mop around baseboards first and pay special attention to removing soil from corners without splashing the walls. Turn the mop head over every 5 or 6 strokes and rinse the ring mop if the area is greater than 3 meters by 3 meters or 9 feet by 9 feet. Repeat the procedure until the entire floor is done, then remove the mop head for laundering, empty and rinse the bucket. If you are using a microfiber mop, fill the plastic basin with cleaning solution. Place microfiber pads to soak in the basin. Then take a clean pad from the basin, wring it out, and attach it to the mop head using Velcro strips. Place the wet floor caution sign outside of the room or area being mopped. Start at the back of the room and work towards the door. Remove the microfiber pad when soiled and when finished cleaning the room, and set aside for laundering. Send the soiled microfiber pads for laundering at the end of the day. Gather all the cleaning materials and leave the bathroom. Remove your gloves and clean hands with the alcohol-based hand rub. If your hands are visibly soiled, you must use soap and water to clean them. Replenish paper towel, linen bag, and waste bag as required. Do not overstock the room. Replace empty soap, lotion, and alcohol-based hand rub containers with fresh supplies as required, but do not top up liquid containers. Remake the bed according to your facility specifications. If the room is carpeted, vacuum the carpet using a vacuum fitted with a HEPA filter. Put on fresh gloves. If the room is not carpeted, dry mop the floor. Start at the back of the room and work towards the door. Do not lift the dust mop off the floor once you have started, and use the swivel motion of the frame and wrist to change direction. Take your time and minimize any turbulence to prevent dispersing dust into the air. Move furniture and replace it after dust mopping, including under and behind the bed. Carefully dispose of debris and be careful not to stir up dust. Do not shake the mop. If the room is not carpeted, wet mop the floor. Please note that disinfectant is not required for floors. Always work from clean to dirty areas. If you are using a loop mop and bucket, place the wet floor caution sign outside of the room or area being mopped. Immerse the mop in cleaning solution and wring it out. Push the mop around the baseboards first, paying particular attention to removing soil from the corners. Avoid splashing walls or furniture. In open areas, use a figure-eight stroke, overlapping each stroke. Turn the mop head over every 5 or 6 strokes. Mop a 3 meter by 3 meter or 9 feet by 9 feet area, then rinse and wring the mop. Repeat this until the entire floor is done, then remove the mop head for laundering. If you are using a microfiber mop, fill the plastic basin with cleaning solution and place the microfiber pad to soak in the basin. Take a clean pad from the basin, wring it out, and attach it to the mop head using Velcro strips. Place the wet floor caution sign outside of the room or area being mopped. Remove the pad when soiled and when finished cleaning the room, and set aside for laundering. Send the soiled microfiber pads for laundering at the end of the day. Remove your gloves and clean hands with alcohol-based hand rub. If your hands are visibly soiled, you must use soap and water to clean them. Do not leave the room wearing soiled gloves. Gather cleaning materials and leave the room. After cleaning, report mold and cracked, leaking, or damaged areas for repair. Return cleaned equipment, such as IV poles and pumps, walkers, and commodes to the clean storage area. Tools used for cleaning and disinfecting must be cleaned and dried between uses, such as the mop heads and cloths. Launder mop heads daily. All washed mop heads must be dried thoroughly before reuse. Clean the housekeeping cart and carts that are used to transport the waste daily.